Hi everyone, today's video is going to be a sunscreen review, a drugstore sunscreen review, and I will be reviewing the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch Sunscreen SPF 45. This is one of the more popular sunscreens from the drugstore, specifically from Neutrogena. I know they have a lot, and under this line, they have like multiple sunscreens. Some of them provide 100 SPF and others like 55. But the one I've got with me is the 45 one. It's quite promising, so as usual, I'll go over all the details that you need to know, such as ingredients, how much it costs, all of that. And I will show you a demo of me applying it on my bare skin so you can actually see it in action. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into today's review. The Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Dry Touch SPF 45 is 100% chemical sunscreen. It is from the drugstore, it's very affordable. You are getting 88 ml and that retails for $11. I got mine off of iHerb. You might be able to get it on a deal and pay much less than this. It usually does go on a deal on iHerb. I would say the lowest price I've seen it sold for was $9. It claims to be water resistant up to 80 minutes. It's oxybenzone free and it's supposed to have a dry finish, hence the name Dry Touch. As I already mentioned, this is 100% chemical sunscreen. It uses four different filters. Number one is evobenzone at 3%. Then we've got homosalate and octacrylene at 10% each. And the final one is octisalate at 5%. I always like to see a mixture of different chemical filters because that usually and generally means you're getting better protection. It's not always the case, but most of the time it is. One notable thing about this sunscreen is that it does have fragrance. Now the fragrance is quite pleasant, it's nothing overpowering, it actually kind of smells quite fresh. But if you're sensitive to fragrance, you know this is going to be a no-go for you. Let me show you what it looks like. I love the packaging on this, it's very sturdy and it doesn't leak or anything. This is what it looks like on my hand, swatched. You can see it's like a typical face lotion. It is a little bit shiny right now and I can definitely smell the fragrance, but honestly, I do personally like it. I didn't even have to wait like a minute and it has already dried down. Even when I touch my hand, I don't feel it on my hand at all. Let me go ahead and show you the demo of me applying it on my face. You can see it does come out the same way. And the minute I went in to apply it on my skin, I actually was confused at the beginning. For a moment there, I thought that this has some type of a mineral filter. It felt similar to a mineral sunscreen. But as I went in to blend it more, I realized that no, it doesn't have any mineral filter. That white cast that you can see, it actually disappeared as I blended it in. And I didn't have any issues with that later on, but I was alarmed at first. So if you were, you're not alone. It does look a little bit whitish. But that's just the color of the lotion. There are no mineral filters, so it shouldn't leave any white cast on your skin, whether you have a light skin tone or a deeper one. I was able to spread it out quite nicely on my skin. It did look a little bit shiny, but as I already said, it does dry down quite quickly. I was also able to put it around my eyes without any irritation or any weird feeling or any weird sensation. The application was quite pleasant, and I did actually later on try to touch my face to see what it feels like, and it felt completely dry, like there's nothing on my skin, and that is something I absolutely love about this sunscreen. This applies amazingly under makeup. In fact, right now I do have it under my makeup and I had zero issues. It makes my makeup look like how it would look without any sunscreen under it, and that is something I really appreciate. You know, with chemical sunscreens, it's really easy to achieve this, but I know that with mineral sunscreens, it's not. So I always say that if you want a sunscreen that looks really good under makeup, initially on application and throughout the day, I always suggest to go in with a chemical sunscreen, and that's what I personally do. If I know that that day I want my makeup to look really good and I want to have minimal touch-up, I just go in with a chemical sunscreen. And this doesn't fail at all. It looks really good under makeup, and the fact that it's water resistant tells you that's going to last much longer than any other non-water resistant sunscreen. One thing to point out, I did feel that this didn't give enough moisture to my skin, so I would say go in with your regular moisturizer and just apply this on top. It's not like I expect my sunscreen to moisturize my skin, but if it does that, then that's an added bonus. But to me, this wasn't enough. Maybe if you've got very oily skin, this might be enough. But if you're normal to dry, I would say still go in with your regular moisturizer. As the day went on, I started to feel a little bit of something uncomfortable in my eyes. That uncomfortable feeling that you would get from sunscreens. Nothing too crazy, nothing that made me want to wash my face right away, but that kind of told me that the sunscreen, you know, it seeped into my eyes somehow, or maybe I touched my face, then I touched my eyes, and I was able to feel it. So if you do happen to get this in your eyes, then it's probably going to sting or make you uncomfortable. But bear in mind, I do have very sensitive eyes. So if you are somebody maybe who doesn't have very sensitive eyes, you might not get this feeling at all. As far as reapplication goes, this looks quite good, like second, third layer. Anything more than that, I would say I would prefer to wash my face first and then apply again, because I would feel that it's getting too heavy on my skin. And I think that is due to whatever is making it water resistant. It does add something to the sunscreen that I can feel on my face upon like second or third layer. But on the other hand, this is a water resistant sunscreen, so that's a good thing. It means you shouldn't need to reapply it as often as you would reapply any other sunscreen that's not water resistant. So let me share my final thoughts. I think this is a great option from the drugstore. It's a really nice chemical sunscreen that's gonna offer no white cast and really high protection, SPF 45. If you've got no allergies or allergic reaction to fragrance and chemical filters, this will be a great one for you. If you've got sensitive eyes, I would say go in with caution. I personally wouldn't be reaching for this as much as I would for like my other staple sunscreens, for this specific reason that I cannot apply it around my eyes. I can see myself using this a lot during the summer for outdoor walks because it is water resistant. It's going to be amazing for that. Even for just going to the beach, you can apply this on your body, on your legs, on your décolleté, wherever. It's going to feel nice. It's not going to feel heavy, thick, or leave any prints all over the place. Let's say you get into somebody's car. You know what I'm talking about. Sometimes you sit somewhere and if you've got sunscreen on, it's going to leave some sort of a print. I don't think this would do that. It literally has dry touch feeling. So that is a great thing, especially for the summertime. That is the time I will be using this, especially also on like my décolleté area, body parts in general. I might apply it on my face, but again, not near my eyes. And because I have so many options, probably not so much. Overall, I think it's a good sunscreen. Is it the best out there? No, but for the price, it is a great one. And if you're eyeing it and you want something that gives you zero white cast and you have no issues using a chemical sunscreen, then I would say definitely go for it. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I would love to know your thoughts about this sunscreen. Leave a comment down below. Subscribe to my channel for my future content, and I shall see you in my next one. Bye, guys.